What's up guys, this is Balazs from Racing Brick. I promised you to show some details about the Simple Technic Hub in my detailed review video of the 42113 V-22 Osprey set, so here we are. If you missed that review, then you can watch it by clicking on the link in the top right corner. So, here is our Simple Technic Hub, or as the box of the Osprey simply calls it, the battery box. If you compare it with the Technic Hub, you can see that the external dimensions are identical. They have the same mounting points, so they have similar space requirements. So, what is the difference then? Well, the most obvious one is the lack of on-off button on the Simple Hub, and it has only two ports compared to the four ports of the Technic Hub. It also has switches to control those two ports and the status LED. And of course, what you can't see from the outside is the lack of Bluetooth connection in the Simple Hub. Now let's see what's inside the box. As you see, the insert that holds the 6 AA batteries is exactly the same, and the battery cover door is also the same. I can simply put the insert with the batteries in the other hub and it fits perfectly. If you look inside the boxes, there are some differences. The Technic Hub has a closed structure, there are no holes to peek through and see the PCB or anything else. The Simple Hub, however, has some holes. There are two actually where you can see the bottom of the switches. Probably the switches could not be smaller and that small gap was required to fit. I don't know, maybe. There's also another interesting difference. This area here is closed on the Technic Hub, but it is open on the Simple Hub. I'm starting to speculate here, but it might be a way to detect the hub type for a smart battery insert, like the micro switches on the Mario set that detect the suit. Let me know in the comments if you have another idea about it. The switches, by the way, can be operated from the top or from the side as well, and you can see how they move through the hole on the bottom that I mentioned earlier. So, as you can see, the switch has a standard pinhole on top. If I put something in it, then it's much easier to operate. First, I thought that it is designed this way to make sure that the top of the hub remains completely flat, but that is actually not the case. If you look closely, then you can see that at both endpoints a little part of the switch sticks out. Let's add some structure to it and see if you can build something on top. Well, as you see, you need to leave some space for the switches, as it will push the beam or anything else that is right on top of it. I wonder if the design could not be more rounded to eliminate this, but I guess the designers knew what they were doing and there's a reason. It is still much better than the situation of the old power function switches. If we compare this hub with the power functions equivalent, then comes the AA battery box and two switches. They have a similar design, but the switch is much easier to operate manually thanks to the extending upper part, but it obviously requires more space as well. It is interesting to see, by the way, that the two power function switches are not identical. Initially they had a direction switch on them, but later on it was removed. As you see, the functionality and the angle they rotate is pretty similar. So let's put some batteries in it and turn it on. There's no on-off switch or button, the two outputs are directly operated by the red switches. If you flip the switch, then the LED turns on and the motor starts to run at full power. All you can do is switch the direction here, there's no option to change the speed. So this is a similar functionality that we can achieve with a power functions battery box alone, or with a power function switch. But if we take the power functions rechargeable battery box, then that had another very useful functionality. You could change the direction and the speed as well with that orange dial on top. I think this makes the battery box much more useful. I don't know why this functionality was not integrated in the powered up Simple Hub. Probably it was an issue with the placement of the dials or the lack of space, I don't know. Adding a speed dial could make an additional challenge as they had to be accessible in a build, otherwise with the wrong initial setup the speed could be fixed at a lower level and you would need to dismantle your build to change it. But still, I really miss this option from the new hub. Here's a quick comparison to see if the mechanical switch has any different behavior than the powered up remote. Apparently when the power is turned off, both motors stop in a similar smooth way, so there's no hard stop command. I try to see if there's any difference in the reaction time, if the physical connection has any advantages over the Bluetooth one, but honestly, both of them seems to have a totally instant reaction. So, how this hub can be used in sets or in custom builds? The first purpose could be similar to the one in the Osprey set. The hub powers a motor that is connected to a mechanical gearbox, so any changes of the outputs are done with function selectors. Another obvious scenario is for GBCs and other stationary builds. You can turn it on and leave it running the whole day without the need of a smart device. Unfortunately, at this point, we don't know when this hub will be available for a wider audience. we either need to wait for a new set with it, or we can hope that LEGO quickly finds a way to make the samples already on stock available through LEGO.com. So, can you think about any cool builds where this simple hub would fit? Let me know in the comments. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my Technic reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye!